Hey everybody, it's Friday and a brand new month, September 1st, 2023. Yes, I am back. My name is Jewel and this is the Weather Channel of J7409. I am fine. I am okay. I did not make a video yesterday because I didn't get a lot of rest the night before. Yes, I had some flooding. But my house is fine. I'm okay. Everything's okay. All right. So I want to thank everybody for their prayers, their thoughts, their donations, watching my videos throughout this past storm of Idalia. But Idalia is still here. And folks, let me tell you what. Please pay attention and watch this entire video. You see five things here. When we go to 7 days, I'm going to show you. There's going to be six things there. So we got a lot to go through. Let's get going. Here is Idalia. She still has 60 mile per hour winds. She's not just going to die. The pressure, 998 millibars, located 32.6 north, 69.8 west. She's moving east-southeast around 16 miles per hour, and more than likely she's going to be affecting Bermuda by tomorrow, Saturday. Here is Hurricane Franklin, 80 mile per hour winds, barometric pressure 983 millibars, located 37.8 north, 57.0 west. He's moving east-northeast around 18 miles per hour. Jose, well, 60 mile per hour winds, barometric pressure 997 millibars, located 33.9 north, 52.0 west. He's moving north around 18 miles per hour. More than likely, he is going to be absorbed with Hurricane Franklin as they move on out. Gert, she's a tropical depression again, 35 mile per hour winds, pressure 1,008 millibars. Located 28.7 north, 55.0 west. She's moving east around 8 miles per hour. Down here off the Cabo Verde Islands, these are showers and thunderstorms. They're continuing to show signs of organization, and they are associated with an elongated area of low pressure just west of the Cabo Verde Islands, a short-lived tropical depression or tropical storm. Now, this is short-lived tropical depression or tropical storm is expected to form today while the system moves northward around, or northwestward, I should say, here around 10 to 15 miles per hour. Now, it's got a high chance of developing 90% 2 days and 7 days. Now, when we look at the 7 day outlook, here we go. We will have six different systems. We've gone over all of them except this one. And this one, my friends, we really, really, really have to watch. It's a tropical wave. It's expected to move off the west coast of Africa this weekend. For those of you who follow me, a few days ago, I showed you one, two, three little systems that were going to be coming across. Well, this is the first one, this is the second one, and this was the most intense one. I expect, unless some things change, which they can, this one is going to turn into a major hurricane at some point. Now, it is expected to move off the west coast of Africa this weekend, and all of the environmental conditions could support some gradual development through the middle part of next week while it's moving westward to west northwestward. Remember that. It's going to go over all the tropical waters in the central part of the tropical Atlantic. Now, in 2 days, nothing. In 7 days, 40. I do expect this to climb up in intensity. And here is the official forecast track of Jose. You can see it will become a tropical storm by the, well, it is a tropical storm, and it's going to stay a tropical storm through this afternoon. Doesn't look like much else is going to happen. I think it's going to be absorbed by Hurricane Franklin and move on out. Still up in these areas, you guys should be okay. Here we have Tropical Storm Gert. She's going to be a tropical storm, but early in the morning hours and maybe late tonight, she should start to come on down in intensification to a tropical depression altogether, right in here. She shouldn't be any harm to anyone at this time. Hurricane Franklin, well off the coastline for anybody, including all of our Canadian friends. It's going to get post-hurricane by early in the morning hours tomorrow, moving on out. And if you remember, Jose was moving up this way. It's probably going to be absorbed in this system up here and move on out with Franklin. So Franklin shouldn't be bothering anyone right now at this time. Now we have Tropical Storm Idalia. You can see poor Bermuda, you are under a tropical storm watch at this time. More than likely, Idalia is going to be impacting you in some ways by tomorrow. So be ready for it. Then she's going to turn. Looked like earlier she was going to turn and come down this way. She has turned a little bit more down to the south, as you can see, off of her track. But then she's going to get swept up. There's a trough up here, looking like she's going to get into. And if she does affect any of our Canadian friends, it shouldn't be anything drastic. You know, the names I get, I couldn't help but smile. Watching people on YouTube and on the national forecast channels, everybody pronounces a different way. It's okay. They make it so it's hard to pronounce, but this is Idalia. Idalia, that's what it is. Now, we've got Jose. The next one coming up is going to be a tongue twister also. It's Katiha. Katiha. The one after Katiha will be one everybody can say, Lee. I just showed you that there is a tropical storm watch up for Bermuda, and it looks like the winds and conditions are possible on Bermuda by tomorrow, Saturday. Looking like the rain will produce amounts of 3 to 5 inches across Bermuda through Sunday night. And of course, the heavy rainfall will likely cause areas of flash and urban flooding on the island. Swells generated by Idalia will affect the southeastern U.S. coast during the next couple of days and will reach Bermuda today. Now, these swells are going to cause, of course, bad surf, rip current conditions, all that stuff. Please don't go into water and please be aware. And Bermuda, go ahead, make sure you're ready for a tropical storm. Here we are at the Euro model. It updated maybe a couple of hours ago as I checked, and this is pretty fair information here right now for everybody. I want to tell everybody I will go through all of the other models throughout the day. I'll check on a lot of different things and focus on main points later this afternoon, but everybody needs to see this. This is Idalia. Okay? Here's Bermuda. It's coming your way. Now, this is early in the morning. Okay, early in the morning today. As we move along in time, we're going to see what happens. Let's go to Saturday. Saturday around 6 p.m., Saturday afternoon. Now, none of these times are wrote in stone. It may be a few hours ahead, a few hours behind. Depends on how these systems move, of course. But you can see Bermuda is being impacted right now by Idalia. This is Franklin up in here. Everything over here, all these other little things, here's one here, here's one here. We're going to have some more coming off. We're going to check them all out real quick as we move up in time. Let's get to Sunday afternoon, see how things progress. As you can see, Idalia will be moving off of Bermuda. Franklin up here, well off the coast of all of our Canadian friend borders here. And as we move in time, we see, well, Gert tries to do a little something. These over here aren't still doing a whole lot. So let's go ahead and move up in time during the week. Say we're going to move up to, say, this coming Wednesday, the 5th, say around 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Looking up in the northern sections, everything's looking pretty good up here. We do have this system right here that has started to form. Now, I'll blow this up in a minute, but you can see it is moving westward, just like it was saying over at the National Hurricane Center. And here is the island chain. Let's go to, say, Thursday. We'll move up to Thursday around 9 p.m. on Thursday evening. Then it starts to move. Looking like at this point, I'm going to blow this on for you. Looking like at this point, it's going to miss the island chain. But let me tell you, all my friends and people from the Dominican Republic, from Puerto Rico, the entire north and southern island chain, you keep your eyes on this system, because I'm just telling you, this is the one I think is going to be a major hurricane at some point. Now we're going to move up to Friday, say around 8 p.m. Friday evening. What is it going to do? Let's see if it moves anymore. Yes, and it increases in strength. Now, I don't have the pressure gradient or the particles on right now, but I'm just telling you right in here. Let's see what it's looking like right now. 86 miles per hour. That's not too bad. But I'm just telling you, as you move up in time, we are going to turn the pressure gradient on in a moment. This is what I'm trying to make everyone aware of. This would be on the 10th of September. Give or take a few days. Once again, you can't say all of this stuff is perfect timing or day landfalls or strengthening or de-strengthening. This is something to go by. I would encourage everyone in the Bahamas, Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and maybe even parts of Eastern Virginia to be aware and stay safe and watch this. 130 mile per hour winds. This is another major hurricane that looks like it is going to progress along and form. Barometric pressure 28.37. Whew! If you've got arthritis of any kind, you're going to know days ahead of time while the sun shines out that it's coming. Trust me. So this right here, it can go anywhere. Looking like, now, let's bring it down in size just a little bit. We got this big high pressure over here, right? We got a high pressure over here. We got a low right here and a low right here and another high that's going to come in here. Well, this one, this is the one that is steering it this way right now, okay? This high pressure is what's steering it this way. Now, it looks like we may have a little trough right here. Now, it depends on how fast this trough moves as to where this is going to go. Right now, it could come over on the east side of Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, maybe Virginia, as it follows this track across, and it could affect the Bahamas too, okay? But what we got to watch is this low system right here with this little bit of low trough. It's not real big. It's got more highs in its favor than it does the lows at the moment. That's why I'm telling everybody now, you know, it can change, but everybody be aware and stay safe. And that's what the tropics are looking like right now. Everybody, please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of what might be coming their way. Hey, I love you guys. Thank you so much for your prayers, your thoughts, your comments, your donations, and watching my videos throughout this hurricane season. I appreciate it more than you know. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.